I mean, when I went to Germany with my model test and I talked to Professor Schuster, who was also a doctor, father from previous years, I knew him very well, and he had been involved in the hydrofoil design of the German Navy in World War II. These hydrofoils were captured by the Russians and started the hydrofoil development in Russia. And he was now an expert on it. When he came, he told me, no, these boats cannot work because the aspect ratio, that is the ratio of beam to cord length, is too small in your boats. You need much more width, but then it becomes unpractical. And the big expert, I was not happy with the answer, but I said, look, here's my results. What do you say to that? Ach, you made a mistake, he said, you know. So that was the end for him. And now I was even more keen to prove to him and people who think this way, here's something new happening. And later we found it out. A hydrofoil tested by itself. It's a very efficient design, but it must have stretch, you know, span width. Then it becomes good. And we had not that. I mean, look at a glider plane. They have aspect ratios over 12, you know, and so on. Very long wings. And then they can glide very long. So that directions we would have to follow, but we couldn't because the practical parameters didn't allow it, you know. But then I found out that when the hydrofoil works in integration with the hull in a very special way, then I get this high efficiency of aspect ratios which you would have to double or so. So there is an interference effect, what we call it, in between the lift creation of the hydrofoil and the hulls. That is what makes the HysoCat. And there are limits to it. If you put the foils on the wrong place, too far forward or so, and the rear foils naturally always at the back, you can get the ship balanced. But when that is too far forward, that interference effect is not appearing and you don't get a good result. And I have seen and spoken with others who also have worked on lifting effects of foils on boats. And once I was invited by John Adams from a company in America who makes seakeeping foil systems for these big catamarans and so on. And they were also interested in that. And he had developed a hydrofoil system, but they call it lifting systems, for an Australian design, and they had built an 8-meter model of it, which they tested in Australia. I couldn't get it working, you know. So actually we expected to get close collaboration with the people, so I didn't hold back and I told him what is wrong in his design. And he had to shift the foil to different positions to get that interference effect. And these people are now too fast and too clever, you know. So he found Australia, they set the foil. One day later, the ship worked.